for us to take it as a matter of urgent legal constitutional obligation on the part of the executive, and for the executive to be seen, what's your problem, respecting the courts of Ghana, indeed the Supreme Court. The ruling was 22nd June 2017, the certain ruling of Sophia Akufo, now the Chief Justice of the Republic. And Mr. Speaker, in that ruling, she was emphatic that within 90 days. Mr. Speaker, within 90 days, this Parliament have not ratified anything in respect of that matter. If you have evidence, bring it. Bring it, bring the evidence. Mr. Speaker, we are raising a matter because the President swears an oath to uphold the Constitution and the laws of Ghana. Rulings of the Supreme Court is law. He cannot be seen not respecting it. So, Minister for Monetary Evaluation, monitor this well. It is a mandatory requirement of the President. Yes, in the ruling, the previous government, headed by President Mahama, erred on the side of the law, which they corrected. And therefore, that judgment must be respected. You either bring it for ratification or you send them home.
Honourable Minister for Monetary Evaluation, you have a point of honor.
I'm surprised the minority leader, who is usually very attentive in Parliament, is choosing to forget that the Minister of Foreign Affairs did bring this for ratification. So when he says that the President is violating the law, I don't know where it's coming from. There's a different issue Ablakha is raising. He's raising a different matter. Mr. Speaker, it was brought to this Parliament for ratification. Now, the government has a right unilaterally to give them visas to stay on. That's an executive decision. It has nothing to do with Parliament. The thing with the American government has been properly ratified by this August House, period. So the President has fulfilled his constitutional obligations. Now, if you want to ask whether or not they are still here, that's a different matter. I don't say that the President has not fulfilled his obligations.
Honourable Members,